Welcome Jacquie Jordan, Emmy-nominated television producer, author of Get on TV, and the recent book Heartfelt Marketing, Allowing the Universe to Be Your Business Partner, founder of TVGuestpert.com.
Hi, I'm Jacquie Jordan, presented here by TVGuestpert.com. We're the industry show with the experts, and we repeat here tonight at 10 p.m. and Sunday at 5 p.m. on AM 1290 Santa Barbara News Press Radio Station, and on the homepage of TVGuestpert.com and on Blip TV. If you want to friend us, you can join us at Jacquie Jordan Inc., TVGuestpert.com. Today's show is sponsored by the non-pharmaceutical hologram chip that helps you sleep at night and the wristband that gives you energy during the day at CX2wristband.com. And today we're actually going to, we got the Santa Barbara Film Festival coming up. And so if you're joining us on the drive time home, it's going to be the 27th of January through February 6th. And I know that when the film festivals come through Los Angeles, where we're home based, it's always exciting because if you buy a pass, you get to see all these fantastic film creators and some of the cutting edge films come out of it. And, you know, not necessarily off the film market, but one of my favorite films this season was The King's Speech, which I actually saw on Christmas Day. So we're going to talk about that movie as well. Joining us on the phone is the Santa Barbara International Film Festival Director of Programming, Candace Schermerhorn. Candace, thank you so much for joining us. How are you?
Good, Jacquie. Thanks for having me on.
Well, we love film festivals, so and we're here in Santa Barbara, so love to hear about the Santa Barbara Film Festival. What are some of the highlights that are going to be that we're going to see in the next week or so?
Well, obviously, the first thing out of the gate would be all of our tributes, which we have James Franco coming for our Outstanding Performer of the Year.
And that's let me just say that right off the top, that's a great booking. He's going to be hosting the Academy Awards. Like, that's a really great get.
Yeah, it really is. It's perfect timing. And I think that it's going to be a really especially good evening. And the American Riviera is going to Annette Bening, and she's going to launch the festival with a Friday night appearance at her tribute.
She's fantastic. I've had the privilege of producing her a couple times as a showrunner for Sunday Morning Shootout, and she's just great. I mean, she's like a down and dirty like actress.
She really is, and I think that's one of the exciting parts about honoring her this year, is that her performance in The Kids Are All Right was just, I think it was a huge stretch. I mean, in the way that she had to go very deep inside and find that character because it was so incredibly emotional. And we all thought that she did an outstanding job, so we're really especially excited to have her here.
Oh, that's so fantastic. So you've got some big tributes, you've got some celebrity talents. What about some of the projects that we'll be screening at the Santa Barbara International Film Festival?
Well, we've got a great To the Max, A Deeper Shade of Blue, that is a documentary, and it gives you the history of surfing, which it's very in-depth. I've seen quite a few surf films, but this is very extensive. It's really, it's got great archival footage. It's wonderful. So that's our To the Max highlight, and that's Jack McCoy, and we're really excited about that. And the To the Max slate, which is really programmed by Russ Spencer. I think that we have some really exciting films there. And our independent slate this year, which it really focuses on English language films, is really strong and has some very innovative work with You Are Here, which is like walking through the labyrinth of one's mind. And we have a wonderful Western from New Zealand, Good for Nothing. Love, Angels and Airways presents Love, which we're really excited about, and they are located in San Ynez, so we feel like it's sort of homegrown. But I know they have, a lot of these films have trailers online already, and Angels and Airways presents Love is going to be, I think, an especially big film in the festival this year.
That's fantastic. And it is an international film festival, so you have entries from around the world?
Absolutely. I think it was up to 49 countries. We have 171 films from about 40, yeah, I think the final number was 49 countries. So it's a pretty diverse slate.
And do you have, Santa Barbara to me is a very special community, especially in its industry relatedness. Do you have a lot of people that come in from, the greater Los Angeles area, other parts of the world to be part of the film festival and screen it?
Yeah, we do, actually. We have people come from all over the country. We have regulars call, from Boston, people from Florida. I mean, they're all over the place, and they'll come up just for that week. We have a lot of people who take their vacation time to come and spend the 11 days in Santa Barbara, which isn't a bad place to spend a holiday.
Right.
And they're from everywhere. And, of course, we have a lot of our filmmakers coming this year. So they'll be, and that will be quite global representation.
As the showrunner for Sunday Morning Shootout, when it was on AMC, we had the privilege of producing that show out of various film festivals. Sundance was, to me, like a college town. It was really quite wild with parties, and very cold. Very, very cold. And then the Cannes Film Festival had such a different energy, such a different vibe. They started releasing tentpole films at the Cannes Film Festival. Uh-huh. And then because we're Los Angeles, Santa Monica based, we've got, the American Film Market at the Lowe's. So it's very different, like different cultures of film festival. How would you describe the Santa Barbara Film Festival, especially for our listeners who won't be listening on broadcast, but will be getting this show, on Blip TV or through our various distributors?
I think that we have, it's a unique situation in that we're an industry-oriented festival and that we're close to L.A. We have a lot of industry people who live in Santa Barbara. So there's that energy here, and yet it's a very, we really like to pay attention to our community, and so and make it very personal for them. So I think that our job over the years has been to try to bring those two things together, and I think that we've succeeded. And another thing I think that really adds to it, in addition to the, ideal weather most of the time, is the fact that all of the theaters are in walking distance. So you really get a chance to peruse State Street, walk through the town, and enjoy the town, enjoy the evening spots, and still be in walking distance of every theater. You can, in between, there's something, going to get something to eat, going to enjoy some other part of ticket. I know that there are going to be some tours, wine tours. I know that there are going to be some city tours and tours around the outskirts of Santa Barbara that are going to be provided by a number of organizations in town. So I think visitors and attendees will have the opportunity to experience the city, experience what's around it, as well as enjoying the film festival.
Candace, we're going to take a commercial break. We're going to ask you to stick around. I'd love to explore the competitive nature of film festivals and also for the Santa Barbara International Film Festival. I'm Jacquie Jordan, and this is the Industry Show with the Experts. We'll be right back.
The Jacquie Jordan Show with host Jacquie Jordan on TVGuestpert.com. Radio KZSB, 1290 AM, Santa Barbara and worldwide.
Alex Detail was a child genius who saved the world from the evil harvesters. But a decade later, this mysterious alien force has returned, and Alex is no longer a prodigy. Now, in order to save the world again, he must survive his kidnapping, fight his evil clone, and get his ship to the planet Pluto, where he will uncover the universe's ultimate power. Alex Detail's Revolution, a thrilling new novel by Darren Campo. Buy online or wherever books are sold.
The Jacquie Jordan Show, presented by TVGuestpert.com on News Press Radio KZSB, 1290 AM, Santa Barbara.
Hi, I'm Jacquie Jordan, and this is the Industry Show with the Experts, presented by TVGuestpert.com. And we're also sponsored by the non-pharmaceutical hologram chip that helps you sleep at night and gives you energy during the day. That's CX2wristband.com. And I'm really excited that we, in the last couple shows, we have finally our wristband. We've just been showing pictures of that. The Santa Barbara Film Festival, we're happy to be hosted here in Santa Barbara, our show originates out of. And the Santa Barbara International Film Festival is happening on January 27th through February 6th. And it's going to have James Franco and a tribute also to Annette Bening, which is remarkably impressive. And I'm on the phone right now with Candace Schermerhorn. She is the programming director for the film festivals. Do I have that right, Candace?
Yes.
And, you know, I, as I mentioned earlier, I was showrunner for the AMC show, Sunday Morning Shootout. We did a lot of the TV shows out of the film festivals. And it was a unique time to witness how the whole film festivals really kind of changed in some capacity the way the film industry did. It opened it up to independent producers and kind of moved it out completely of the studio hands. How competitive is your film festival, and what do people do to prepare for it and to get into it, into the film festival?
Well, I think that I think Santa Barbara has really become a competitor in the festival circuit. And one of the things that we really love to do is focus on the independent filmmaker. And most of our slate is really independent film. We certainly have some of the bigger line items, so to speak, that we're presenting, but the slates, the competitive slates, are full of independent film. And I think that one of the things that we try to do, because of where we're situated in the calendar also, is try always to create a fresh slate and not to replicate the programs of other festivals.
Right.
Great festivals that have come before us. So we really try to scour the world, really, globally, to look for the gems and look for films that might not have gotten the exposure that they deserve. And we also, when we're programming and looking at films, we're not only looking for a great film, but we're also looking for up-and-coming talent, people who are showing that they have something and that maybe they are talent to be noted for the future. And so, you know, to prepare for it, a filmmaker looking at what we're trying to, you know, what our goals are, which really cater to independent filmmaking, I would say, you know, give it a shot, because you never know. And I think that's one of the things. I mean, there's always a limitation of time and
sure,
the numbers of slots, but you just never know. You never know what you're going to
who's
be gonna up
see
against,
it.
Who's
yeah.
going to see it, who's going to who's going to have the opportunity to be in your audience.
Right. You know, I have so enjoyed being an attendee at film festivals, because if you're a film buff or a movie junkie, you get to go and see, you get exposed to filmmakers and projects that you just would not actually see.
And oh, yeah. And filmmakers, too. They have the opportunity to be there and talk to audience members. And, you know, being an independent filmmaker can be a very lonely road,
yeah,
in terms of, you know, being able to get exposure and being able to interact with people when they see your film. So standing in front of an audience, you know, who appreciates your work is, I mean, there's nothing more rewarding for independent filmmakers.
Do you do, does the Santa Barbara International Film Festival also feature shorts as well as,
yes.
Feature
yes.
length?
Mm-hmm. We have, this year we have three competitive shorts programs. All three programs are up for the Bruce Corwin Award for short film. And then we have two slates of animation, and they're all shorts as well.
You know, I'm just kind of laughing because our radio show producer, Stephanie Kobian, and when she was in college, I was invited to screen their college submissions on movies, feature films, their projects that they did. That was a night of torture, I just have to say. Except for Stephanie, who's actually won, and that's why we have her. But that was a night of torture.
Well, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. And when you're screening, you really want to be able to give the films the chance that they deserve.
Exactly. forgot about that moment.
It's definitely a commitment. When you sign up to review, it's definitely a commitment.
It is. I forgot all about that. It's also bringing back for the Academy, for the Emmys. I think I was put on like mini series, and I had to watch two 20 mini series. I'm having flashbacks, as you can imagine.
Sure.
But I do. I love, getting to see the expression of filmmakers. And I think there's so many fantastic shorts. What happens to the films after they, do a run in the Santa Barbara International Film Festival? Do they go to Netflix? Do they still try to find distribution? Do they go on to another film festival?
Well, I think that's what, that's a dilemma that faces every single filmmaker. What happens next, no matter what festival, no matter where you are. But, there's always the struggle to find distribution. And so Netflix and online distribution, places such as Netflix are always a great option. But I think the distribution model has changed so much with VOD and then with all of these, a lot of the new options that are coming out related to the internet. But every single one, you're really trying to look for the revenue stream that's attached to some of those so that you might actually recoup some of that cash that you've probably put on your credit card.
Right. I also think that film festivals and theater in general still offer a community experience, which home movies do not offer. And when you're seeing things for the first time, that it has a community experience, which I think is still, I think people still long for that. And it's a form of entertainment that I think people like to feel at least mutually connected in the experience of viewing it.
I think so, too. And I think that, the role of, I think that film festivals are still very important.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that their role is constantly changing, just as the distribution model changes. I think that the mission of festivals is starting to change. And, to look at what they have to offer a filmmaker and to make that experience as positive and as fruitful as they possibly can.
And admission tickets are still available, Candace, for people who want to come and screen the films?
Absolutely. Yeah, they can. If you go online to our website, which is sbfilmfestival.org, you can find a link to ticketing, and that will give you all the details of how our particular ticketing system works.
You can get a package of three or a package of ten, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you get a four pack, a ten pack. You can get different types of passes. You can get, and it also explains the queues and what the queues mean so that you don't have to wait in line, space savers. And so all of the minutiae, the details of making your experience manageable are all online.
Candace Schermerhorn, the Santa Barbara International Film Festival Director of Programming. It's January 27th through February 6th. Candace, thank you so much for joining us. And I'm Jacquie Jordan. This is the Industry Show with the Experts, and we'll be right back.
The Jacquie Jordan Show with host Jacquie Jordan on TVGuestpert.com. Radio KZSB, 1290 AM, Santa Barbara and worldwide.
We were born before the wind, also younger than the sun.
Alex Detail was a child genius who saved the world from the evil harvesters. But a decade later, this mysterious alien force has returned, and Alex is no longer a prodigy. Now, in order to save the world again, he must survive his kidnapping, fight his evil clone, and get his ship to the planet Pluto, where he will uncover the universe's ultimate power. Alex Detail's Revolution, a thrilling new novel by Darren Campo. Buy online or wherever books are sold.
The The Jacquie Jordan Show, presented by TVGuestpert.com on News Press Radio KZSB 1290 AM Santa Barbara. When I see you,
I run out of words. Hi, I'm Jacquie Jordan, and this is the Industry Show with the Experts, presented by TVGuestpert.com and sponsored by CX2Wristband.com, the non-pharmaceutical hologram chip that helps you sleep at night, and the wristband that gives you energy during the day, especially if you're driving home right now, ready for your weekend. We just spoke with the Candace Schermerhorn, the Santa Barbara International Film Festival, because that's going to be going on January 27th through February 6th. On Christmas Day, I had the opportunity, I didn't even, went to the movies, which a lot of people do on Christmas Day and the holidays. I didn't even know the movie. They said, let's go see The King's Speech. I went with my boyfriend, and I hadn't heard of it. It was the most charming, delightful movie. I don't know if anybody in here saw it, but it was just so sweet. And joining us on the phone right now is David McGuire of the McGuire Program, located here in Santa Barbara. They've got actually a global program for Beyond Stammering, which was kind of a theme that went on. It was the theme, the crux of the movie, of The King's Speech. Dave, thanks so much for joining us. How are you?
I'm doing pretty well. Good afternoon.
So you obviously saw The King's Speech, because what I think is so brilliant about what you and your wife are doing with the programming and what we teach at TV Guestpert is you're taking a pop culture news hook and you're using it to promote your business. And you couldn't have landed a more perfect topic for your business. Tell us a little bit about your business.
Well, that's... First of all, I have to say that in waiting to come on, my whole heart was really pounding because I used to be a very severe stammerer myself, and it just brought back the memories of when I was a kid in class and waiting for my turn to read.
Ooh, we all feel that here.
And I really haven't felt that in a long time.
Wow.
But anyways, yeah, this is a real good challenge for me. So we have a worldwide program. It's called the McGuire Program. It's something that I'd had a lot of speech therapy, and it really didn't do me any good, except this one at UCLA where it was by this psychologist who basically approached it from the psychological standpoint of what you're really afraid of is stammering itself. And by stammering on purpose, you can fight fire with fire and really bring down the fear and everything else that will cause you to block and the whole stammering behavior. It was I really didn't work hard enough at it, but it allowed me to go back to school and to get my degree in psychology and to go on to a career in adolescent psychology. But my stutter could still be quite bad, and I was over living in Holland for a while, and this old opera singer taught me what's called operatic diaphragmatic breathing. It's by breathing by expanding your ribs, and I would apply that to my speech, and suddenly, this very severe problem, and the speech therapist called it incurable, because it's really, once you have it as an adult, it's very hard to treat, as you saw in the King's Speech.
Yeah, it's so tough, though, when people put labels on things like incurable, terminally ill. People are going to be so careful when they declare what is.
Right. So after a while, I actually gave up on being able to do anything about it.
Mm.
And in a pressure situation, it would be so bad you could barely understand a word that I said. So, and then just with this operatic diaphragmatic breathing, it was suddenly I was speaking pretty much like I am right now.
Mm-hmm.
And being able to do things beyond my wildest dreams. And so I applied the psychological stuff that I learned from Dr. Sheehan at UCLA and worked with people in my own house in Holland. And then they would be helped as much as I would. It was a tremendous help. And then...
Well, you know, I know in the King's Speech,
right,
there was this, you know, first off, the pressure that that soon-to-be king, the prince,
right,
was
right,
under to, one, live up to a throne. I mean, that was his birthright, was the throne. I mean, that in itself, that pressure there would have made anybody breathless.
Right.
They started the film where he was, you know, put up to having
exactly
to do that big public speech. And, you know, first off, the fact that he was put into a position which he, you know, wasn't articulately confident to do was so painful. And I think that, and you know, and then that him and his unorthodox therapist really worked at the kinks. And for him, it was a lot of emotional stuff. Like, I, you know, and you witnessed it. You felt like it had nothing to do with the words. It had to do with all the pressure, almost like weighted down his own ability to talk. You know, is that just a theme for the movie, or is that part of the challenge?
Well, it really is a brilliant movie. I mean, in that first scene, it really captures what we go through in a tough situation, where everything's just freezing up. You could barely get a word out, and all the shame and the guilt and the self-hate and everything, and the way it was at Wembley Stadium.
That's right.
London there, and
oh, the pressure
on national radio. Now that was some pressure there, and they captured that really well, and that is indeed what we go through in these. Now, see, all stammers, I mean, have periods of fluency. For example,
sure,
I could talk to my dog fluently. I could, you know, I could talk to myself fluently. I could, of course, I could sing fluently. But when it came to a pressure situation where there was something on the line, I could barely get a word out. And I believe they captured that pretty well. Like when he was telling a story to his little girls, he did fairly well there.
Yes, he
okay?
did.
Only in a real tough situation, he could barely get a
yeah,
word out.
Yeah, when he
and
was confronting his older brother, he,
right,
he
exactly
was speechless.
Right, yeah. And it, you know, and it's a very complicated affliction. And, but, you know, as I developed my program, I saw this is more and more like a sports. It's like performance fear gone wild.
Well said.
And so, you know, you have to come to terms with that psychologically. You really have to accept yourself for who you are. Right now, I'm totally fluent, totally confident about 99.99% of the time. But there are situations like this one right here where I can feel it trying to come back on me, but. Like an athlete, and I played fairly high-level tennis, and I was able to apply those same contests. You have to work on your technique. You got to clean up the technique first, right?
Right, right, right.
And then you have to work on the psychology, on who you are.
Right.
And with accepting yourself for who you are.
Right.
And right now I'm David McGuire, who sometimes stutters, and I'm working on speech. And I'm working to become articulate and eloquent.
David, I'm going to ask you to stick around so we can take a quick commercial break. And I want to hear more about your eloquence and how you work at it. I'm Jacquie Jordan, and this is The Industry Show with the Experts, and we'll be right back.
The Jacquie Jordan Show with host Jacquie Jordan on TVGuestpert.com. Radio KZSB, 1290 AM, Santa Barbara and worldwide.
Was a child genius who saved the world from the evil harvesters. But a decade later, this mysterious alien force has returned, and Alex is no longer a prodigy. Now, in order to save the world again, he must survive his kidnapping, fight his evil clone, and get his ship to the planet Pluto, where he will uncover the universe's ultimate power. Alex details Revolution, a thrilling new novel by Darren Campo. Buy online or wherever books are sold.
You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place.
The Jacquie Jordan Show, presented by TVGuestpert.com on News Press Radio KZSB 1290 AM Santa Barbara.
Beautiful day. Thank you so much for joining us on your drive home today. And if you want to listen again, we'll be on tonight at 10 p.m. and Sunday at 5. We also run on Blip TV and on the homepage of TVGuestpert.com. Today we're sponsored by the holograph chip that helps you sleep at night and the wristband that gives you energy during the day. That's CX2wristband.com. And we were talking earlier in the show about the Santa Barbara International Film Festival that's coming up on the 27th through February 6th. And we're also talking about what I, at least in my opinion, think is one of the best movies of the Christmas season, which is The King's Speech. And from Santa Barbara, I've got David McGuire on the phone from the McGuire program, who helps people overcome stammering, which was what the film was about. And our studio producer, Richard Dugan, brought up a really good point during the commercial break. He said, you know, Jacquie, you're not ruining the ending of the movie because the movie isn't about the ending. It's actually about the process of the movie. So if you haven't seen the movie, I haven't ruined anything for you. But David McGuire sharing his real life account and how he's overcome it and helped other people achieve stammering, you know. And David, because, you know, I'm in the business of helping support people get their messages out and their presentation through TVGuestpert.com. And, you know, and when we deal with people who are public speaking, there are usually typical things that people get scared about when they have to make a public speech. You know, one of the things is they're afraid they're going to be asked something they don't know. That's the number one reason people freeze up. But stammering is like a whole nother dimension to the challenge of getting up and you were saying, you know, before we took the break, that you have to work on this.
Yes, I do. I mean, I have to. Well, in other words, there's this basic cycle of speaker we developed. It's when you pause and you center and clarify yourself, and you take what's a full costal breath, it's called, and then you try to project your voice, you know, with some nice deep resonance, and you release your residual air. And then, see, I used to not be able to say my own name, David McGuire.
Wow.
I can never say that, right? But in Holland, when I was living there, it's considered impolite to not answer the phone with your name, with David McGuire, or just David McGuire.
Wow.
So once I got this, I realized that I was really onto something when I could answer the phone with my own name. And then, you know, every so often I'd have trouble, and then you have to do things to overcome the struggle and the distortion and the freezing that happens in the articulators, the vocal cords, and also in the diaphragm. It's a very complex sport, this speaking.
In The King's Speech, there was a huge psychological component involved in his stammering. I mean, you found out through the course that he was abused,
right,
and neglected. Is that a psychological component, a trait of people that have stammering, or is it a mechanical?
Oh, it's almost, well, yeah, it's almost all psychological. It starts from there, where, say, when you're learning how to speak as a kid, and there's several theories about what causes stammering, but I just happen to believe it's very much like, you know, these structures, diaphragm, vocal cords, articulators, you know, these structures develop at a faster rate and some slower in others, and you have what's called primary stuttering. And
mm-hmm.
It's that normal bumbling and stumbling that you see in little kids.
Sure.
And if too much pressure, too much attention is brought on that,
it exacerbates the symptoms.
Right, and it exacerbates them, and the child starts thinking, well, you know, there's something wrong with what I'm doing. You know, there's something wrong with the way I'm talking. There's something wrong with me.
Right.
And if that pressure keeps up, you know, and then they we'll start using these tricks
to escape
a little, and start avoiding certain words, start avoiding situations, and then it turns into what's called secondary stammering, where
I can't relate to it from a perspective of speech, but I went through this period in high school where I would pass out in health class. It was anxiety related.
Yeah.
And you know, nobody could have rationalized with me, like, don't panic, breathe in a paper bag. Like, if I was going, mm-hmm. I was going. And you know, and it's
right.
crazy to have an anxiety displaced issue that comes out physically.
It's called a cycle of panic.
Yes.
Cycle of panic, where, you know, the. Where the fear of stuttering becomes self-perpetuated.
Right.
Okay. Better not say, oh my God, I have to say my name to the teacher. I can't say it. I better not stutter. Better.
Right.
Well, it's like in a sport, if you play tennis, you know, and you're in a match and you're thinking, better not double fault. Better
right.
not double fault. What are
you
going to do? You're going to double fault.
Right.
You know, everything tightens up. Everything tightens up, and it becomes almost a self-fulfilling prophecy. And it's one of the things psychologically that we have to teach. And you know, I have to say, because everybody in the program, in the McGuire program, has been through the program because they have a stutter.
Mm-hmm.
And
right.
so we know what that fear is, that anxiety,
right.
and that cycle of panic that you experience in your health class. And the way you deal with it is you fight fire with fire, and you it's like, well, okay, if I'm so afraid of stuttering, I'm going to even stutter more.
Right, of course.
And
that's what would happen with the fainting. The more people made a big deal about me passing out, the more I was going to hyperventilate and pass out, and it wasn't like rational.
Yeah,
it was
yeah.
you know, some sort of like crazy teenage anxiety I was going through. So I relate to that. You know, Dave, it's the McGuire program. It's
yes.
I know you're global, but you can be found out of Santa Barbara. I can't thank you enough for like the courage, you know, to come on and share your story. And you know, and from a business perspective, I respect that. You know, this is a great time to get that message out there, because there's nothing worse than suffering in isolation with something like that. And you have people who've been through it who can help you. Where do we find out more information?
Well. You could go to the website. It's www.beyondstammering.com.
Excellent, excellent. David, thank you so much for joining us. We're the Industry Show with the Experts. I'm Jacquie Jordan, and we'll be right back.
The Jacquie Jordan Show with host Jacquie Jordan on TVGuestpert.com. Radio KZSB, 1290 AM, Santa Barbara and worldwide.
Just in time. I'm so glad you have a one track.
Detail was a child genius who saved the world from the evil harvesters. But a decade later, this mysterious alien force has returned, and Alex is no longer a prodigy. Now, in order to save the world again, he must survive his kidnapping, fight his evil clone, and get his ship to the planet Pluto, where he will uncover the universe's ultimate power. Alex Detail's Revolution, a thrilling new novel by Darren Campo. Buy online or wherever books are sold. The Jacquie Jordan Show, presented by TVGuestpert.com on News Press Radio KZSB, 1290 AM, Santa Barbara.
Hi, I'm Jacquie Jordan, presented here by TVGuestpert.com and sponsored by CX2Wristband.com. And we're the Industry Show with the Experts. And joining us on the phone right now is one of my favorite television guestperts, Lanie Adamson. She's a medical ghostwriter whose expertise crosses the line and range of ghostwriting, literary projects, medical ghostwriting, but she's also a public speaker, which is how I met her the first time. It was public speaking, and she's got a great wit, a sense of humor. Lanie, thanks so much for joining us.
Oh, Jacquie, this is a great pleasure. I think that I follow along with your previous guest in that I have the other end of it. I have Parkinson's disease. And so this is something I have to deal with in my public speaking.
Right, 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 which is why I really appreciate you coming on and joining this conversation and sharing that intimate that piece? Because you're somebody, quite frankly, who you're expressive and you like to talk.
I do.
So this disease is quite inconvenient, wouldn't we say?
Yes, it is very inconvenient. And you have to deal with it the same way that your previous guest was dealing with it. You have to take it on and understand it and keep going. You have to keep going.
What did you think of the movie The King's Speech?
I loved it. I loved it. Whenever, in the beginning scenes, whenever Prince Albert was going up to speak at Wembley Stadium, and he had to speak into a microphone, and it was carried by radio, and his face, as he tried to speak slowly and painfully.
Painfully.
Oh, but it's like inconsolable despair.
Totally. You wanted to die. Like that was the beginning. Like, you wanted to die. Like, and you were. I was sick to my stomach in just that moment. I was like, oh.
That one. And whenever he was talking with conventional speech therapists and they wanted him to put marbles in his mouth, I kept saying, he's going to swallow one. We're not going to have to worry about who gets to.
It essentially was like humiliating him in the treatment. It was was another level of pain, like just more humiliation on top of more humiliation.
Absolutely.
And you know what I love about what you do is, you know, you are expressive in your public speaking and your sense of humor. And your other outlet is writing. You do both medical professional writing and creative writing.
Yes.
So, you know, does that help balance out, you know, the challenges that you're dealing with right now?
Actually, you've hit the nail right on the head, because I do still have that outlet. And my public speaking will depend on how I'm able to cope with this and whether there are any drugs that can be taken. Mm-hmm. But I do have the other outlet of writing.
Which is so fantastic. What projects are you working on right now?
I'm working on a couple of screenplays. And I never thought in my life I'd ever write a screenplay until the opportunity came up. So I'm working on a couple of those, and I've got a book in progress. It's completed, and now going through the review process with my co-authors. And just occasional business and medical writing occasionally.
Well, what's been fascinating about knowing you is that you're somebody who's like, you know, you've had a wide range of career and you know, in terms of your media stuff, especially where we've gotten to witness and champion you have like arced later in life.
Yes.
Which is so delicious, especially, you know, in a medium that's considered, you know, quote unquote young. You've certainly, you know, put yourself out there in a lot of different arenas, from screenwriting to book writing to television to radio to public speaking. And what is your message today that you carry?
My message is that you must keep going, and you can conquer things one thing at a time. But my message is definitely that you need to keep, putting one foot in front of the other, no matter what comes your way.
Lanie, thank you so much for joining us today. If you want to find out more, it's Lanie Adamson. It's Lanie Adamson.com. Or you can check her profile out at TVGuestpert.com. I'm Jacquie Jordan, and this is the Industry Show with the Experts, and we'll see you here next Friday at 5. Take care.